15 minutes into a show, I started talking about how someone called me racist when I criticized Michael Vick. And then this guy started vomiting words. Just everywhere.
No.
What?
No.
No.
He's retarded. Retired. Which is it?
He officially retired?
Yes.
When?
The other...
Tuesday.
End of the season.
Once at Tuesday, once at the end of the season. You seem to know your facts, because the season ended Tuesday, so...
No. Last season, he's done.
That's... Okay, I'm a sports writer, and that's not what he said, but cool. He's a Jets fan, come on. That's why I don't trust him.
I've got red hair.
You've got red hair? Okay, that changes nothing.
Wow, we got into the present.
Got into the what?
Present.
Present?
Yes, you're a comedian. You're supposed to speak in, you know, your general terms.
I'm supposed to... I do what the fuck I want. I'm not supposed to do shit. I don't even know how this started, but I didn't mean to rub meat from your seat.
He's a Jet fan!
I know he's a Jets fan, and that's why the Jets fucking suck. So... I hope that you are right. I hope he never comes back, okay? I hope he does. But it doesn't change how I feel about him. And it doesn't change how I feel about the Jets, because they still signed his sorry ass.
Yeah. Hey, I'm a Falcons fan, so you're right on.
Can we just move the fuck on and back to the joke? Is that okay? I was trying to... Do you see that, like, smooth transition I was doing? Where I'm like, I don't care, and here's how. I was like, but no, we should discuss this more. And he's like, speak in present past participle, and I don't fucking care. Here's how comedy works. Sometimes I'm going to talk about things that you have opinions on. And you just have to hold them. Have the thoughts. Think of stuff. Think of the thoughts. And then hold them. And then after the show, release the thoughts in the wild. But for now... Like, I bet everyone in here has an opinion about something I've said. I bet there are some people who have children who are like, no, my kids are good, and they're smart, and they're brave, and they would never stick their finger into outlets. But they didn't be like, fucking outlets! Like, they didn't do that.
I segued back into material, which worked for about 20 minutes. And then he wanted attention again.
Don't you fucking stop.
Or say Jets.
What?
Or say Jets.
Or say Jets. Was that the same guy?
Yeah, damn straight.
That's the same guy. You're calling attention to when you fucked up? Everybody in this room had forgiven you. And was like, don't worry about him, it's okay. He's rooting for the Jets, it's okay. You're like, no, it's still about me!
Sorry.
That's okay. I know.
I did invent a new word, though.
You did invent a new word?
Yes.
What? Jets?
Plagiarism.
Plagiarism? That's a new word?
Well, that didn't go over.
No, it didn't. Because it didn't mean things.
Ah, he got stuck again.
You invented a new word. And the word was the word for stealing another word.
Exactly!
Oh, you are bad at this. You are really bad at this. Have you ever done stand-up before? Have you ever done stand-up?
I did some sit-down once.
You did some sit-down. This is why you've never done stand-up. I'm just glad you could keep the streak alive tonight. What do you do for a living, sir?
Are you talking to me or my wife? Good.
Well, I said sir, so... I don't know how your marriage is, but you should take that one the fuck back quickly. Unless you want to sleep by yourself forever. Say, because sir was short for Shirley Beautiful is what I thought you meant. Sir, the guy...
What do I do for a living?
What do you do for... Who pays you money for stuff? Because I'm going to have a talk with them.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, what do you do for a living?
I fly drones.
You fly drones?
Yes.
So what do you work for, Amazon? Like, what do you...
I have a great routine on racism.
You have a great routine on racism. You don't even know what the word plagiarism means. I don't want your opinion on something as volatile as racism. He wants me to do my routine on racism.
Yes, that's it.
Okay, what race are you? Because I'm doubting whatever the fuck it is right now. I can't see you from here, so right now, whoever you're representing is embarrassed. Oh, you said you had red hair earlier. Fuck! Oh, it's us. It's us! This is why I get shit, because of people like you. Because you walk around the world being an asshole, and other people are like, fuck redheads. I'm like, no, just that guy, just that guy. Just the drone-flying Jets fan who thinks his wife is a dude, just that guy. When you watch, like, videos of, like, cars hitting people, are you like, I want to be hit too? Like, is that...
No, we're redheads.
We're redhead. Don't fucking... There's no we right now. There's no we. Each of us are individual redheads. Coincidentally. Red, what's your name?
What's my name?
The questions are only going to get harder. I figured I would start with an easy one, because apparently what do you do for a living fucking stumped you, so I figured I'd go backwards a bit.
I'll sit up a little bit.
You'll sit up. I still can't see. It's the lighting is why I can't see you. It's not because you're slouching. It's because light's in my face and not in yours, and that's why you can see me and I can't see. It's a trick. It's magic.
Yeah, my name is Bob.
Your name is Bob?
Yes.
Okay, that is not true.
No, it is!
It really? It is?
That's true.
Thank you, sir. I didn't even dislike the Jets that much before the show. I'm gonna root for every quarterback's leg to be snapped just to fuck with Bob. I'm just gonna be like, Bob will be very upset when this happens. I'll just be at home eating popcorn being like, fuck Bob. That's what I'm gonna do. And his wife's gonna disagree because she's like, he called me sir. I'm not gonna fuck him ever again. With Bob. I know we both have red hair, but we're very different people. And you can't just trade up like that. You can't do that. The worst part is, I honestly can't see you guys. I don't know what they look like. I'll figure it out after the show when someone comes up to me with red hair and is stumbling around. I'll go like, that one's Bob. But I don't know what his wife looks like, or his girlfriend, or whoever, or his ex, whoever it is by the time the show ends. And so she might come up to me, and I won't know, and she'll be like, great show, and I'll be like, thank you so much. And I'll have, like, a regular conversation, and I won't be like, you're the one. I won't know. So we need the rest of you to help me out. If it happens, if I'm at the table and they come over, you have to be like, that's Bob and his wife right there, that's Bob. I am terrified that Bob controls drones. By the way, if you agree with my basic stance on stupidity, you should pick up one of these t-shirts after the show. It says, your stupidity offends me. Bob's wife, you can just draw an arrow on it if you want.
Mark Shoemaker, a comedian who does a lot of his set about being a teacher, was opening for me. During his set, there were two women who were texting a ton and talking to each other. By the time I turned the camera on, he had already politely asked them to stop three separate times.
She said sorry again, that went right back. Is everything okay on the home front? Let's be honest. I'm like getting a little worried. It's just, it's too familiar to me, that's all. I really want to take it away.
During my set, I told a story about someone being stupid in a place called Laverne, and then I segued into another bit about how I don't like most people. The two women in the front were still talking to each other and not paying attention to the show at all. Just talking in between bits and over bits and just whenever they got the chance. Everyone around them was getting annoyed, and so was I, but they weren't actively trying to interrupt. So I started out a little nicer than I usually would be, and just asked them to be quiet.
Could I ask you guys to not talk as much, since you're a foot or two from me? You done texting? Do you mind picking it back up so you stop talking? Okay. I can deal with the blue light, but the whole time I can't. Just occupy yourself with something. Some of you think I'm being mean. Some of you guys are like, yeah, I know. Okay. You said you're from Laverne? You just said close? One city away. Okay. You realize we're only like 40 minutes from there. A lot of people are from close to it. And yet they all had managed to handle the joke quietly. Is anyone from Luverne itself? Yeah? And yet you didn't need to tell me. I know you're just trying to participate, but it's not a participatory sport. So, okay.
It kind of worked, because they were quiet the rest of the show. They were scowling at me, they were super fidgety, and they were still texting a lot, but at least they were quiet. We all know someone like that. Someone who just can't sit still and be in the moment, ever. So on my last joke! They just couldn't take it anymore and had to speak up. The joke was about how unsafe it is that people can take one road test and keep their driver's license for decades.
Now in California, you have to take the road test again? You have to take the road test again in California? The written test? No, you don't, but thanks for incorrecting me. You guys are 0-2. No, you renew by mail. Only for so many years? No, that's not true at all. Here's the weird part about this joke. I knew it ahead of time. So I research, keep telling myself that. Okay, what about all the people who are agreeing that also live in California? Has any of you had to do that? Here is what you're thinking of. What you're thinking of is when you transfer an out-of-state license. You don't care? Then why did you interrupt me? It seemed like you really cared. Like, there was a moment where I was talking about it, and you're like, I care enough to interrupt you, and now that I find out I'm wrong, now I don't care. Y'all were doing so well. You were sitting quiet the whole show, and I was really proud of you, and then this is my last joke, and you were like, let's try again. I know you mean well, but just don't... You don't mean well? Then you can leave. Right after you file a major complaint? That's the fun part. I'm taping the show. File all the complaint you want. Who are you going to file a complaint with? Is there staff in the room who saw this happen? There's no need to be rude to the other 200 people who are trying to watch my show. I care way more about all of them. Okay. Keep going. No, you can leave before I finish. I don't want you to hear the end of this joke. This joke is for them. Is it okay if they go early? Did they already pay their tab? Yeah. Hold on, no, I want to do this the right way. I want to make sure they already paid their tab and it's cool because they need to hurry up and file a complaint. You let the Better Business Bureau know that when you interrupted my show and I responded, that was very rude of me. The person who rear-ends somebody and then complains that they stopped. Because I had moved on. And then you incorrected me. Do you see all these other people laughing? And you're like, you guys are doing it wrong. Alright, if you want to stay for the end of the joke, you're welcome to. Because that way you know exactly what to complain about. So what was I talking about? Oh, right, I don't like people. And so... So my point is, you get your driver's license when you're 16, then you never need to take a test again. Or maybe you do. I don't know.
Here's the amazing part. The only reason those two would assume that I was wrong about the driver's test is if it happened to them, right? So I did a little more research, and there is a reason you might have to take your driver's test again in California, if a neighbor reports you as an unsafe driver. So I guess someone filed a complaint.